Second Epistle of John. The elder unto the elect lady and her children, whom I love in the truth, not I only, but also all they that have known the truth. For the truth's sake which dwelleth in us shall be with us forever. Grace be with you, mercy and peace from God the Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the Father, in truth and love. I rejoice greatly that I have found of thy children walking in truth, as we have received the commandment from the Father. Now I beseech thee, lady, not as though I wrote a new commandment unto thee, but that which we have from the beginning, that we love one another. And this is love, that we walk after his commandments. This is the commandment, that as ye have heard from the beginning, ye should walk in it. For many deceivers are entered into the world, and confess not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. This is a deceiver and a antichrist. Now, we're taking part where we left off last week, because time goes by too quick. We're on lesson number 31, 2 John. We're picking up from lesson 30. This is a deceiver. And we talked about television. We talked about Jacob. We looked at 1 Samuel 28, verse 17, where Halloween and King Saul. You know, Halloween, where you go out and be who you're not. That's a deceiver. That's your movie world. People get up on the screen and deceive you to think they are someone who they're not. Genesis 31, 7. Talking about deceive. In Genesis 31, verse 7. I'm in the wrong chapter. All right. I think that looked right. 31, verse 7. And let's start verse 1. And he heard the words of Laban's son, saying, Jacob has taken away all that was our father's, and of that which was our father's has he gotten all this glory. And Jacob beheld the countenance of Laban, and behold, it was not toward him as before. And the Lord said unto Jacob, return unto the land of thy fathers and to thy kindred, I will be with thee. And Jacob sent and called Rachel and Leah to the field unto his flock, and said to him, I see your father's countenance that is not towards me as before, but the God of my fathers has been with me. And ye know that with all my power I have served your father. And your father has deceived me and changed my wages 10 times, but God suffered him not to hurt me. Jacob, for deceiving his father, and that was back in Genesis chapter 27:12, the first place that deceive shows up. Jacob deceives his father. Now Galatians 6:7, be not deceived, God is not mocked. Whatsoever man soweth, that he shall also reap. Jacob is reaping what he done to his father by his father-in-law. Now he doesn't like it. But what we're looking at is not as far as the sowing and reaping, we're looking at being deceived. The first deceiving that Laban done with Jacob was he switched wives in the middle of the night. He was supposed to get Rachel, and he ends up with Leah. Now, with this account with Jacob and Isaac and Jacob and Laban, you better realize that deceiving is a lie. And you're going to reap what you sow. You better not get involved with lies and deceiving. Jacob lied to his father on who he was. Laban lied to him about wages. I was once told that a lie goes halfway around the world while the truth is putting his pants on. When truth is getting the pants on, the lie is already going around the world. A lie is quicker than the truth. God is all truth. And I wonder who the liar is. If God is all truth, John 8:44. I'm not sure if we looked at this passage last week, but John 8:44. See who the liar is if God is all true. Sanctify him through thy word is true. So let's see about John 8:44. Ye are of your father the devil, small l, and the lusts of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, so he didn't abode in God, because there is no truth in him. And when he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. So lying and deceiving is conceived by Satan. When Rebecca told her son, let's come up with this Halloween thing, and you know, to get the stolen blessing, stolen, you know, to steal, thou shalt not steal. That was concocted in Rebecca's heart from Satan. When Laban shortchanged Jacob, that came from the heart of Satan, the source. Deceiving, there will be a payback. And the Bible word for that is called reaping. And it may not be on this earth. You may reap it before the judgment seat of Christ or the great white throne judgment. Before God Almighty. Deceiving is lying. Not being who you are. Not giving what you said you would give. Deuteronomy 11:16. You know, there are occupations out there that are known for deceiving. Are known for lying. Would a Christian value from them? Can a Christian be involved in an occupation that is known for its lies? Why would you? The Bible says abstain from all appearance of evil. Why would someone of God, not of Satan, be involved in something that is known after the works of Satan? Because he is the liar and the father of it, so if there's an occupation that is known for lies, I'm going to tell you in my words, according to the scripture, that abstain from all appearance of evil. A Christian has nothing to do with occupations that involve lying or anything that deals with a lie. Now that's going to be kind of hard in the world that we live in today, for it's Satan's world, run by Satan. Matthew 4. Luke 4. But you know, again, there are occupations that are just, they're jokes. And it's known that they lie. Deuteronomy 11:16. Between you and the Lord. You got to pray about it. Take heed to yourselves, Deuteronomy 11:16, that your heart be not deceived. And turn aside and serve other gods and worship in them. Your heart. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness. That very thing that you turn to God. Can be deceived into serving other gods. A lie. That is the warning of one or more warnings that John is starting now and stating. He's going to get into deceivers. As we look at deceiving and what its contents. We're going to get into, through John, we're going to get into people who will lie to you and not give you the truth and will not give you the full goods. Do not turn from God to gods. Do not turn to God with a capital G to gods with a small g by these deceivers. If your heart can be deceived, woe unto you. You are given a warning in the Bible. For it takes the faith from the heart, and I quoted to you Romans chapter 10, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness. That belief that you have in salvation can be stolen away. And the Bible says you lost your first love. And you can't lose your soul, but you can lose your love, you can lose your fellowship with God. You've gone back to the enemy, you're going back into the arms of Satan, you're committing adultery against God through the enemy. That's why John writes his second epistle, this small little letter about deceivers. And many of Christians have fallen to the wayside. Particularly in their infancy, in their growing. And they have become spiritually retarded. Stunned of growth by a deceiver, a lie. You cannot lose your salvation, but if Satan can turn your heart from God, all the destruction that he can do, all the destruction that Satan can do, the loss of rewards, and think about what God will do to you. You're not going to have his blessings. You're not going to have his mercies. As a matter of fact, if you are his son, God, as your father, will chastise you until you come back, till you return, till you repent, or you just go so far away and God says, listen, I'm putting you on the show, or death. There are Christians out there today that have gone so far. They're beyond help. They're saved, but there's nothing you can do with them. There are Christians in a graveyard today because they were deceived. And you know Christians today, or maybe I'm speaking to you, you're deceived in a religion. You're saved. You're not beyond that breaking point. Repent. Get back to God. Get back to your heart salvation of repentance, of salvation, of belief on the Lord Jesus Christ as the Bible states who he is and not who religion says he is. Paul tells us that there are another Jesuses out there. And you may have fallen for the false Jesus. That is not lined up with the Bible. If you are involved in a religion that Jesus came to North America, you've got another Jesus. If you are involved in a Jesus that is not God and God is not Jesus, you are been deceived. If you are into a Jesus that's going to come back on a certain date, you messed up. You need to repent. You need the Jesus of the Holy Bible, the King James Bible, that is God, and God is Jesus. That is seated at the right hand of God right now. That we are in the church age, under grace. No works, no tongues, no signs. You may be under another Jesus. And when you're under another Jesus, you have been deceived by Satan and his works of the flesh. Second Samuel 19:26. Bible has a lot to say about being deceived. Because God does not want you to be deceived. He's warning you. Because it is possible. Without being in the Word, without a prayer life, without seeking God, even myself can be deceived. You say, really? I mean, you're teaching the Bible? You've been saved many years? Yes. Never think that you cannot be vulnerable. Never think it will never happen to you. Never think that. Because it can happen to you at any step. Because all you got to do is make a wrong step in a wrong direction. And you're on the path to being deceived. Again, I tell you to read your Bible. And I tell you to read the second most sold published book, Pilgrim's Progress. Because even Pilgrim in the book has succeeded into a way deceiving. That's Doubting Castle. As he is deceived by, I think it's Mr. Worldly Wiseman, as he goes about the law, and Mount Sinai is going to throw upon him and kill him and crush him. He was deceived. And then there were two men, I forget their name, but you know, they come to three-way paths. Pilgrim goes up the hill. The two companions go either way, being deceived and end up in death and lost. 2 Samuel 19:26. And he answered, "My lord, O king, my servant deceived me. For thy servant said, I will saddle me an ass, that I may ride thereon and go to the king, because thy servant is lame. He has slandered thy servant unto my lord the king." See? The Bible is its own dictionary. Slander, deceive. Deceive and slander. Deceive is saying you will do something and you do not do it. Now, no one has ever thought that. No one is really guilty of that, are they? Brother, I'll pray for you. And then you don't. You become a liar. You've slandered. And you deceive. That guy thinks you're praying for him. That guy thinks you did pray for him. You ever, any time in your life, said you'll do something, and I mean, situation called that you were unable to do it, but you said you'd do it? You become a deceiver. You slandered. You lied. That's why a Christian ought to say, "Lord willing." Because you don't know what's going to happen. I can tell you right now, I'll meet you at 4 o'clock. I don't know what traffic's like. I may get in an accident. I may have to make an emergency stop. Something may come to be where 4 o'clock will be unreasonable. But if I say, "I'll meet you at 4 o'clock, Lord willing," it's enough said to say you do it and you didn't. Job 31:9. "If my heart has been deceived by a woman." As you follow us as our family studying right now, We're going to the book of Proverbs. Our nightly study. Deceiving is found in Proverbs as a warning, and a woman can deceive a man's heart. Solomon warns children, his son, many a time in Proverbs about a woman. Jezebel deceived Ahab, even though he was wicked himself. She added more with her wicked ways. Solomon, for his life was ruined because of all his wives that he married that were involved in other gods. The strange women that the Bible speaks that Solomon married deceived him away from God to gods. Was exactly what we read in Deuteronomy 11:16. Satan can use love, or a woman, doesn't have to be love, to deceive you. You need to be warned of that. For love, man has fallen. Now the Bible says that Adam wasn't deceived, but the woman was deceived. But because of love for Eve that he had, he ate the fruit. Now the woman was deceived by Satan. There are many things and warnings in Proverbs. Proverbs 20 verse 1 says, wine and strong drink deceives.
I can drive, yes I can.
Every drunk thinks they can, they're a boxer and they can beat everybody up.
I can quit.
An alcoholic is deceived. I can quit. This is my last time. How many drunken prayers by the porcelain throne have you not done?
Oh, that was my last drink. I'll never do it again.
You're deceived. This bit you. Proverbs 24:28 speaks about deceitful lips. Salesmen, politicians, a man, a woman. There's no other race of humans. A pastor of a church. Television and radio, religious programming. Their mouths. You don't think it's possible? Have you read the trial of Jesus Christ before the Sanhedrin? They sought false witnesses. That's a liar. That's a deceiver. And many came, and the deceivers couldn't even match with the deceiving lies. The false witnesses could not even agree with the false witnesses. That's the mess you got on Capitol Hill today. Proverbs 26:18-19. Practical jokes are meant to deceive. You think it's funny. April Fool's is a deceiving, lying holiday. With the foundation of Satan. Satan's birthday would be Halloween. His anniversary would be April Fool's. Nowhere do you see Peter, James, and John and Jesus going around cracking jokes or playing tricks on people or treats. Trick or treats. Have you looked up the word trick? Oh yeah, we changed the word to trunk. It's just amazing how churches will change the word treat to trunk, but they'll turn around the pulpit and say, you know, shack it up, it's fornication or adultery. But you take a Halloween word and you change it to another word. That's okay. Jeremiah 29:8, false prophets and diviners deceive. Lamentations 1:19 says loved ones will deceive you. And Obadiah chapter 3, pride deceives. And these are all tools that Satan will use. He'll use, I'll do it, and then you don't. He may use a woman. He may use wine or strong drink. He may use lips. He may use practical jokes. False prophets may use pride. Or he may use a loved one. You got to be careful. Remember what we read about deceiving? It deals with the heart. And Satan will use a lie or deceiving, John 8:44, to stick a sword into your heart to break it. Remember what Luke chapter 2 says about Mary? It says a sword will pierce your heart when you see your son. I can name you right now half a dozen Baptists I know, their family destroyed them. And then they move away from the family that destroyed them. I know. I can give you the names. I'm not going to. I can give you names where lost family members have destroyed a Christian. Have destroyed a marriage. Has crept into a church and caused scars. Alright, in the New Testament, Matthew 24, verse 4, is the first place deceive shows up. Deceive first shows up in the New Testament, Matthew 24, verse 4. Again, 24 chapters into the Gospels, and this shows up. 24:4. And Jesus answered and said unto them, now here's a warning. The first place it shows up in the Gospels in the New Testament, it's a warning by Jesus. Take heed that no man deceives you. Well, didn't we just see a woman? Didn't we just see family? Didn't we just see false prophets? Somebody who plays jokes on you? Didn't we just see somebody who has lips? Who will deceive you? Satan will. And what will Satan use? He'll use man. You know what you gotta do? Every human being you deal with, you gotta pray about. Saved or lost. Listen, saved Christians fall by the wayside too. You got to be careful. Jesus warns just as John warns. How's that? Isn't that enough to think that I need to pay attention to this book, epistle, whatever you want to call it? That the same thing that John's going to do to his elect lady, Jesus is telling his disciples. Before he leaves, in Acts chapter 2, in ascending up to heaven, Acts chapter 1, excuse me, he warns them. Can it happen? Go ask Paul in 2 Timothy chapter 4 about Demas. And what did it say? He loved someone with the world. Love. Heart. Adam loved his wife. I guarantee Solomon loved his wives. Not like he married them for money. He had the money. So you know what a tool that Satan will use that he does not have as an attribute? God is love. Satan is not. We read it John 8:44. Satan will use men and he will use love. How do you ruin a young girl's chastity? You get her in high school in the back seat of a car. And you rock and roll. She's defiled. Though she may put a white dress on when she gets married, whatever time, she's defiled. Marked as a fornicator. How precious is it to save yourself to the day you say, I do? And then when that husband and wife, newlyweds, join themselves together to be pure. But if not, you've been deceived. Even if the first person you've done it with turns out that you later on you get married, still, that's not Bible purity. You have been deceived to think, oh, let's do it now because we're going to get married later. Call the word fornication. Satan has deceived you to not to wait. So he can use love. He uses man. And he attacks the heart. Because that's where your foundation of your belief is. Now watch the next verse. For many, that's a lot. Not all men, but many of them. Not everybody is a deceiver, but many. There are so many out there that you got to pray. Shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. Many will get many. And then many will get many. And you got too many manys. Well, don't you think that if a Christian is to produce fruit, good fruit, don't you think that the evil tree that produces the evil fruit will be the many here? That's something to think about. Listen, deceivers go out and get other people to deceive them. Okay. They're going to be calling themselves Messiah. And you know what? Many will believe it. There was a guy down in Texas. And many believe he was who he said he was. Many believe that Jesus came to North America to the Indians. Many believe that Jesus is not God. Many believe Jesus in the healing and abstain from meat. Many believe in Jesus speaking in tongues. Many believe in Jesus if I eat and drink him. You see what I mean? By the way, that last one, the Catholic Church, That is families bringing up their families, bringing up their families, bringing up their families in a religion that's false. Many bringing many. History has proclaimed it. Romans 16:18. Can I give you another little warning that's not in my notes? I'll be turning to Romans 16:18. Here's a warning. Write it down. Write it in your Bible if you have a Bible marker. Don't you be a deceiver. You better speak the truth. Sanctify them through thy word. Thy word is truth. You better speak the Bible and speak it properly and correctly. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a man that needs not a man that right. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a man that needs not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Rightly dividing. You could be a deceiver. You may be a deceiver. Or you could be a deceiver. Come out and be a past deceiver and come into the truth. Romans 16:18. For they that are such serve not our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly, and by good works and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple. The young. Those who don't know anything. And they just want to feed their big fat belly. A lot of them show up at a lot of these banquets and big dinners and I was in a church where I don't know how fellowship time and skip out and Sunday night service was often. Matter of fact, I was told me and my fiance that if we didn't attend the fellowships after church, we weren't going to be married by that guy. And you know who you are. That church is a mess today. I wouldn't even go in that church to say goodbye to the people I knew in that church when I came down to Florida. It's a part of what John is warning us. Even totally different that John, Paul, and Jesus are warning us. Should we not get the message? They have fair speeches. Turn on the radio. Where do they get these voices from? I have never heard anybody speak out in the public or at the store that have these voices that they have on the radio. My pastor is on the radio and he's got a normal tone of voice. I listen to many types of preachers that are on the radio and have cassette tape. They have a normal type of voice. But you get these other ones in there, I can't even explain the tone. And good words. Not the holy words, good words. Not the word of God, it's good words. Now I'm going to tell you something else about those people. If you're involved in them, the deceivers on the radio. Now they're great preachers on the radio. You got to know the difference. But those that are deceivers, those are for their own belly. There are people paid to write what they say. You know, when you watch those televisions nightly, people that make you laugh and, you know, they invite people. That's not their words. They pay people. It's a script. For you to, oh, isn't that guy just so... No! Somebody thought of those jokes for him. That ain't him speaking. That's the writers that are in a room locked that you don't see them. And the only thing you see later on is their names quickly in the credits. You are being deceived to think that that guy came up with that as an original idea. I'll tell you another thing I know with preachers with deceiving. There are preachers out there that have preacher stories. I've heard a preacher say it, and like, oh, wow, interesting. I'll hear another preacher, and he'll tell them the same story. I'm like, wait a minute, that guy said it happened to him. So this guy say it happened to him. And I'll hear another preacher, he'll say it happened to him. Wait, wait a minute. Telling the same preacher story over and over by different, that's deceiving. I know it's true. All right. With Paul, John, they're writing to this lady and her children and to us not to be simple. Go back and with our audios or videos, whatever you want, and go back through our Proverbs study so far, especially Proverbs chapter 1 as we go through about the simple. Go through the Bible marked simple and study the simple. Don't be simple. Grow. A false check of your true character. Galatians 6:3. For if a man think himself to be something, when he is nothing, he deceiveth himself. Don't ever think again it can never happen to you. Because at that point you will be deceived. At that point you may have been deceived by thinking it will not happen to you. Satan has been dealing with men since Adam. October 24th, 2014, I have no idea how many men have been on this planet. Men and women, male and female. God and Satan does. And God and Satan has been dealt with every single male and female. Satan knows where to get you. And he only has three resources. And those three resources has been working from time of man to today. Some believe sin will never catch up to them. They'll be scot-free. Read Galatians 6:7. Be not deceived, God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that he shall also reap. Get it down. May the mercy of God not have you. But, oh, you say, well, I'm going to reap it. You just may lose rewards and glory. A lot better than losing a family. A lot better than losing your material. A lot better than, I mean, what is it? See, it's not better than the worldly stuff. And it's not better to lose a crown or all that. You don't want to lose anything. You don't. Lastly, we need to grow in the Lord and in the Word. That will prevent deceivers from attacking our hearts. Ephesians 4:14. I'm going to just read the last paragraph here. We're stuck on time. I'm going to give you some references. I'm going to read the last paragraph. We'll be done. Ephesians 5:6. 1 Timothy 2:14. Titus 1:10. James 1:26. 1 John 1:8. Revelation 12:9. I'm thinking my eyes are starting to go a little. Revelation 12:9. Revelation 13:14. 18:23. 19:20. The main source of deceivers is Revelation 12:9. The great dragon was cast out, the old serpent, called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out into the earth. I'm having a hard time reading right now. My allergies, forgive me. And his angels were cast out with him. We already read John 8:44. And 2 Corinthians 11:14-15. and no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers, his, Satan's ministers, also be transformed as ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. Deceiving is of Satan by lying, attacking your heart by men and even love. John, Paul, and Jesus warns us. Solomon, in the book of Proverbs, warns us over and over and over. You think Jacob was pleased, was happy when he got deceived by Laban? He ran for fear. But you think Esau liked it when Jacob deceived his father? And Jacob got a payback from his father-in-law for what he'd done. Don't be involved in deceivement. Or deceivers and everything you can go. Don't be involved with it at all. Stay away from it. Don't go to them and don't be one.